have some relevance for the listeners. So now, can you define a little bit of what do you, one of the ideas that came to me by listening to what you just said was that now if there are short-term goals and there is a bit of a long-term goal. So suppose the short-term goal is to do a good job right now with whatever you're doing, even at the cost of personal sacrifice, if that is what you choose. And then there is the long-term goal. In 5 years, I have achieved this kind of whatever it is, ABC. Now you're saying that this so-called spirituality, I am calling it so-called because it is your journey as of right now. I have not experienced it. I have my own journey. There are other people who have their own inner search, seeking, whatever you want to call it. So you're saying one needs to enlarge the focus of this is the world. This is what things are. This is what we are. And then within that, this is this little short-term, long-term goal and happiness or unhappiness. So this is smaller than the entire existence. So once we acknowledge that there is a bigger world out there, there are bigger things, there are families, there are friends, there are concerns which may not be relatable to us immediately, but they are still relevant to people whom we care for. Mm-hmm. Very often my daughter finds that I don't respond when she has a school project. So I try and do some jugaad and I'll give her some general direction and say that you do finish this, then you come later. So by then my job will be done, guys. So very often I find she doesn't come back. And once or twice she's actually complained that you are not taking enough interest. So I have to then tell her, look, because I'm working from home does not mean that I'm really available, unfortunately. But I find myself very unhappy about the fact that I'm unable to give her time and be part of her learning process. So I try and ask, okay, what did you do? And what were your friends contributing? How are you guys interacting? So some stuff I try and do. So out of 4 projects, sometimes I try and participate at least in 1 or 2, if not all 4. So this is my question to you. By spirituality, when you said that when your parents introduced you to spirituality, you're saying they widened your world in terms of, oh, there are other aspects to life besides this short term. Do you mean that? And can you give any example that the penny drop happened for you? Oh, I never thought about this. Anything like that?
Yeah, so I listened to a lot of talks done by a lot of the spiritual leaders. I don't say that, you know, I have to, you know, this particular God is what is spirituality is. Spirituality is something that there is a larger force of nature that I believe in. That sort of drives everything. So that is what it is. And, it's a lot about subconscious mind that people keep on saying. So, my mama has this thing, you guys always just, have fun, do this, do that. You never listen to what I want you guys to learn and stuff. So, unka simple funda tha, wo TV ka volume on kar dete the, then that particular episode used to come. She is called as VK Brahma Kumari Shivani Saurabh. And I used to run to my bedroom and close the door. But, ki ye bahut क्या चालू है यार, आई एम नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस, आई डोंट वांट टू गेट इनटू दिस, मामा लेट मी डू माय ओन थिंग सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग. बट वॉल्यूम इतना हाई होता था कि वहां पे भी मुझे यू नो अननोइंगली सुनाई देता था और मेरे सबकॉन्शियस माइंड में होता रहता था. इवेंचुअली यू नो आई इवन आई डिडंट रियलाइज, वन फाइन डे आई वाज इन द वॉल्यूम लिसनिंग टू हर एंड आई वाज लाइक नो यार दिस मेक्स सेंस, यार दिस मेक्स सेंस. मुझे लग रहा है सिर्फ बूढ़े लोगों का रहेगा ये, नो बट इट आई कैन एक्चुअली रिलेट टू इट सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग. So that is how this entire incident happened. That is how I was sort of introduced to spirituality is what I would say. And then, you know, they have this very simple real life things that they say, ki, achha, tumhara long-term goal. For example, is to buy that ultimate house or an ultimate car. Aapko wo khareed ke kya milega? What will you get out of it? Happiness. So matlab, your ultimate goal is happiness. These are just the things that will make you take, which will take you there. So that struck me. Yaar. I'm like, yeah, true. Yaar. End of the day, I just want to be happy. My way of happiness would be by buying 10 cars and your way of happiness would be by just sitting with your daughter and doing several things. So that is different. But our ultimate goal in the life is like live and let live, everyone in peace and be happy. So I think, yeah, that's...
No, once you have those 10 cars, please gift one to me. I'll still want to be your friend. Okay, very nice. Since I want to contextualize back to the relationships that we were talking about, so effectively when one starts taking care of oneself, paying some attention or trying to get an understanding of where we stand vis-a-vis ourselves, then it automatically leads to more clarity in terms of how you deal with others. Would that be the connection that we are talking of as of right now?
Sorry, come again. Like,
so for example, because you started paying attention to yourself and started understanding yourself better, so then the irrelevant things of running after one deadline to another, and you started pausing to, you know, figure out whether that works or not. Or maybe you're just finding time to look back at yourself and say what makes you happy. Right?
Yeah, I think like currently if I have 10 things and my friend say or anyone says, okay, let's meet up or I want to do this particular thing over the weekend, for example. So now I draw deadlines. Okay, I have office work over the weekend. There's no escaping to that thing. But am I investing 10 hours or am I investing 5 hours? That is something that I need to draw a line about. So, you know, even right now I have like one project that needs to be done. But I'm like, you know, it will be done. I will give this one particular time to them. But weekend, as family will be home, I have to dedicate 2 hours also where my laptop is entirely shut and I am spending time with them. And, you know, just like it's a Sunday, you all lay back, you just talk what happened over the weekend and stuff like that. That earlier was not important for me. I was like, ye kya baat karni hai? I will just work and I will just finish my deadline sort of thing. But now I feel ki, no, yaar, that is what matters. Like, you feel happy. They're like, and inside you are satisfied. Okay, you are with, you know what your brothers are doing. And you know what's happening around you. Like, you're not self-focused. Ki, okay, I just know what's happening in my life. But I actually do know ki, what's happening in lives of people that are around me. And, you know, if they need any help or if they're just happy. Like, whatever is happening, that sort of thing.
I think that's very beautiful because I want to bring two things. One, the contextualization of what we spoke about. You actually gave a practical example in terms of how distancing yourself from your immediate problem, which is the project that you wanted to do, gave you the bigger picture of what is happening in your family and your brothers and your parents and or maybe even your friends at times if they call you and they discuss any kind of thing, relationship issues or business issues or job issues. So you know what is happening in their lives and maybe there is something to contribute. My question to you, I want to decode this spirituality bit because it's too much of a hocus pocus involved, unfortunately, in the world about these matters, spirituality, meditation, mindfulness. Suddenly they sound so big and so important that they look like, you know, this is not for me, yaar. I don't have time for such holy or spiritual. There are so many people, when I want to talk such stuff, I find initially a lot of people used to find it very either boring or very, very unnecessary. They would rather talk about which new movie release or where do we go to party this weekend or...
That is very important.
I'm not even denying that. But I was, fortunately or unfortunately, even at a party, you would find me discussing such stuff because this was what intrigued me. But what I meant is that within this whole setup, there was never any space for any other opposing point of view. So now that, like you just said, it's very important. There's another good aspect that you brought in. So there are many aspects to you, Sheetal. There is the party goer, there is this family person, there is this solo time that you have for yourself, there is this workaholic also. I still don't find that you have, you're not as good. I find you still as good. So I have never found out that you are not up to it if I've asked you a question. Or follow-ups, or there is the friend, Sheetal, that people want to be in connect with and they want to talk about something. So you are able to manage all of these things. Is it much more possible because you realigned something internally? Is there an answer which is beyond all these? Because the whole is greater than the sum of its parts somewhere. These are parts. Again, we are looking at it that you're doing well, or obviously there will be days that you still not do well enough. So if two people are clashing, sometimes our friends and family clash. That itself is a thing difficult to solve because they want to party on the same weekend that the family wants to go out. Little things like those happen. So my question to you, is there an inner realignment that happened that brought about this change in you? One fine day you can't be listening to a discourse and saying everything is all right. That sounds a little dramatic.
Of course. No, so it's basically, now when someone says something, I don't jump to give an answer. I rather take some time and think about it. Log pehle wo log bolte the na, chal aaj aapko party jana hai. Like, yeah, let's go. Or if with parents, if there were plans, I would always say ki nahi, nahi jana hai. But abhi, you just take back, you think, you give some time ki what is more important currently. Like, to keep that balance ki tumhe, like you have not spent a lot of time with your family, so you should do that. Or is it friends bahut mahino se nahi mile, so do that. So at that point of time, both the things are equally important for you, for me. But then at that point of time, what is more important is what you sort of realize. And we, I would say ki, oh yes, listening one fine day is not, it's not a thing. Like I said na, meri ma mahino tak she tried doing this loud volume wala thing is one fine day I got up in my room. And then I started actually listening to it. So every evening, I used to have this half an hour sort of thing. But I used to just listen and understand ki, and they used to dissect everything. Okay, you have negative thinking. So how, like, is that okay? Or you should not have that thing. You always start thinking ki, haan yaar, if I'm thinking bad about this person or if I'm thinking negative in a manner, I obviously don't want that, but it keeps coming back to me. Ki, okay, why does this thing happen only to me and stuff like that. So you need an external force who's helping you to bring you out of that, marshy land, as I would say. And just listening to all these things somehow helps you find that direction, helps you give that direction to your life. Keep, this is what it is next. That sort of thing.
Okay.